Today we're going to be looking at the sc203 modular z180 computer kit from Stephen C. Cousins, which could be considered as an RC2014 clone. The kit comprises of three modules: the z180 CPU module, the z180 memory module, giving you 512k of RAM and 512k of ROM, and the backplane. The backplane has 6 vertical slots and 1 additional horizontal slot. As you can see from his website, it is very well documented. And this is a nicely expandable system. If we have a look at the documentation on the backplane, we can see the backplane itself is extendable to an impressive degree. And each of the modules comes with very good documentation, right down to an assembly guide. Firstly, we'll have a look at what comes in the box. Right at the top of the box is our documentation. As there are 3 boards to build, we have 3 documentation sheets. One on the backplane, clearly illustrating all of the components involved in putting it together. The second one is on the memory, again displaying very clearly all the components and how to identify them. And the final documentation sheet is on the CPU kit itself. Again, all the components are clearly illustrated. In the well put together box are all the bits we actually need: the circuit boards, the components, and the chips. So what we're going to do today is we're going to put together the backplane. So we will dig out from our box all the components we need to put that together. Right, so here is the circuit board for our backplane. And we'll identify from the sheet all the other components we're actually going to need. All the components we'll need for this backplane are in this one clearly identified pack, SC112. The normal approach I take for these is to fit the lowest profile components first. So we will dig out the resistors and the capacitors. Now, looking at the instructions, we have 2 resistors and 7 capacitors. And they have now been identified. So in order not to lose anything, we'll put everything else back into the bag for the moment. Now, while the capacitors are all the same value, the resistors are different. So we need to identify the resistors. And the documentation does have a clear picture, so we can actually see from the colour coding which resistor is which. But if you're in any doubt, use a multimeter to check the value of the resistors, so we can identify on the board where resistor 1 and 2 are to be fitted. There's resistor 1, and there is resistor 2. Right, we will just solder these into place. And as always, examine your solder joints to make sure they've been done correctly. So that's the resistors in place. Let's now identify the location for all our capacitors. Now we have 7 of these to fit, so we can see quite easily they all appear to go down the centre of the board here. And we can now solder these into place. As always, take your time when soldering these together, as it's time well spent and saves you time debugging the system later on. Now that we have the resistors and capacitors in place, let's look to see what we next need to solder into place. And for fitting our on-off switch, we will place it flat to allow it to be soldered into place easily. And that is our on-off switch securely in place. Now we'll go for the reset switch. it should fit in here. And again, we'll place this flat so we can solder it into place. Right, we're making some progress now. Now I think we'll start to put the edge connectors in place. Now there are quite a number of these to fit. Now with all these lined up, we can now start the soldering. And that says at the halfway point, we just have to turn it over and do the pins on the other row now. Should complete all the solder joints. Want to check to make sure we haven't missed anything. It's also important to make sure you haven't welded any two joints together that shouldn't be, as it's very easy to add a little extra bit of solder and connect two things that should not be connected. Yeah, those headers are now all in place. Right, what's next to do? Now we have a little connector which can plug in here, and we'll solder that one in place. And we want our barrel jack. So that's now securely in place, and that just leaves our LED to go in. Hey, that looks fine. Let's just snip these off. One more thing to put in, and that's this, which I should probably have fitted earlier. Let's see if we can get something in place to hold that there. Right, let's just use a piece of blue tack and we'll see if we can sit this in place. That will hold it in place long enough for us to do the soldering. And there we are. So that's everything soldered into place. We now have our board completed. And the only thing left to do is to fit the jumpers. We can put these in place once we complete the other boards. However, that's it for today. Thank you for watching.